So, Confide Administrators. I made many screencasts already demonstrating how to set up a Confide Administrator, but I'll do another one just to make it as simple as possible. I'll try to make it as simple as possible. So I'm logged into this remote system, which is a Red Hat Enterprise Linux system. 6.4 I think it is. Anyways, so I'm logged in as a staff user, so I'm going to basically create a new confined administrator for Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6. So let's see which processes we have running on the system and see if I can find a process that I can confine. So let's make ourselves a NTPD administrator. So basically a user on the system that is only allowed to manage NTPD. So basically that means restart the NTPD, restart the NTPD server, and edit the NTPD conf. That's basically, it's simplified. You can extend that later to allow it to do other things, like for example edit the init script itself or stuff like that. But we'll keep it as simple as possible, and in the meanwhile I'll also show you where to look for examples, because this is pretty common stuff and it's supported in Red Hat Enterprise Linux, but yeah, it's not very well basically marketed, so it's kind of many people don't know that it's basically supported, or at least there are ways to simply do that. So let's go ahead. I'll open up the Eclipse browser. In the meanwhile, you don't need it, but I use that. So let's create a working dir. Where am I here? So let's create a working dir just for our new policy, because you have to write some policy. Now this is some stuff that is unrelated. So let's just make dir my NTPD NTP admin. I'll call it my NTP admin. So let's just cd into my NTP admin dir that I just created, and let's create a my NTP admin type enforcement file. Oops, and of course, oh, and there's a this is really a minimal system, so that sucks. Anyway, so let's just declare a policy module, which is basically done with this statement or macro, basically my NTP admin, and then 1.0, and then let's see if the current policy already has some APIs that I can use for this one. So let's just go to the Fedora policy. You can also use the browser. We might just do that. This makes it a little bit easier, probably. So there's a website where you can basically browse the policy, and it's here, this at this URL, and then basically go to the contrib branch. But this is Fedora, but I can just use some of the ideas here, and then browse the tree. So since we're going to create a confined NTP admin, the NTP policy module might have some API for us to use. And if it doesn't, so if your service does not have a policy or a module, then you can basically create your own policy, but you can basically base that on examples, for example the NTPD, if that actually exists, and else we're going to use another example. But basically you can get inspired by how it's done. So MN, where's the N, damn it, NTP. So, and then it's in the interface, if it's there, it's in the interface file. The interface file provides APIs to a particular module. And here we have actually the NTP admin interface API. And basically this API provides all the all the access you need to basically create a confined NTP administrator. So let's just copy and paste this over. And if it doesn't, if your particular administrator doesn't have a corresponding API to use, then you can basically just use this stuff to create your own, just inspire it. So basically what we do is we'll just copy this over, and instead of creating, well, we could actually we're not going to, we're going to do it the simple way, or at least the simple way, in another way. So basically we're going to remove all this stuff. This is made tunable, but we're not going to make this tunable because basically this is for Fedora, this policy for Fedora. So this is basically some stuff that's needed to administer a NTPD server. Basically what you get is these are rules basically to actually access the process. So for example, you can send it signals, and then you can basically PS that process, that NTP process. This is, these are the rules basically that allow you to restart the service in the proper domain. So that's basically needed to make sure that you can run the service in a proper domain. And these are basically the rules to manage the various contents. So you can manage the NTPD log, you can manage NTPD temporary files, the NTPD PID files, and here you have the unit file, but this is not, this is systemd related, and that's not in the Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6. So that's, so let's just keep it this way. And then basically, as you can see, there are some parameters here, and these parameters need to be replaced. But these are just the rules that allow someone to manage some content. But first we also need to create a new user role. So how we go about that? So in there, in the user domain, which you can also find here in the tree, but if you don't, you don't really actually, we need to go to the master branch and then go to the tree and look for the user domain module. Modules, and it's in the system layer, and then you have the user domain module here all the way below, and it provides some interfaces that you can use. And we need this API, the user dom base user template. Basically, this sets up a default role that you can use, so you don't have to really remember the details about this, but if you create a new role, then you'll need the user dom base user template. And the user base template expects a user domain prefix, so a single parameter. You can call this API with a single parameter, which is a user domain prefix. So in this case, we're going to create a user with the name myntp-admin. So we call this myntp-admin. So this basically sets up a new role that we can use, and that's basically all you need to do. And then, so basically this template basically creates types for myntp-admin, a type identifier and a role identifier. I think it's probably, there's a role identifier here, so that should work. If it not works, then we'll see that later. So, and then we can basically edit these parameters here. So the S1 parameter is the domain parameter. So that case, we're going to use the domain identifier myntp-admin-t. And the same is here. This is also the first parameter, and it's not MTP, but it's NTP. So this is NTP, and it's my. So being, because I specified myntp-admin, so it's going to be myntp-admin-t. Basically, that this template creates those types that we're using here, going to use here. So paste that in, myntp-admin. This is also myntp-admin. It's parameter one, myntp-admin, and then this is the parameter two, which is a role. So instead of myntp-admin-t, this is going to be myntp-admin-r, and the same goes for this one here. Paste myntp-admin role, access to the system role, and this is the type again. So basically that's pretty much it to create a NTP only administrator. So let's just do that, paste and that also to allow it to manage those files. And there's one unfortunate thing here, that it doesn't support the, I think it doesn't support the NTPD configuration file, but we'll add that in there if possible. So now we have basically pretty much the base set up. So let's just save and exit that, and let's just have a look at the ntpd conf. LSR etc ntp conf. Is it ntp conf or ntpd conf? And it's actually ntpd conf, but some smartass decided to label this net configuration file. So basically that sucks, because if we want our administrator to be able to manage the ntpconf, then we need to allow him to manage netconf files, and there are other files that are labeled with the netconf t-type that are not ntp specific. So that sucks, but let's just ignore this. Just ignore this one and this rule, so this administrator won't be able to edit the ntpconfig file, but you could basically hack around that. So we have this my ntp admin policy module. Let's see if this builds on our Red Hat Enterprise Linux system. So you'll run the make f user share se linux devel make file command, and if the proper files are installed, then it builds, and it builds. So we have now our module. Now there's one single thing that's missing in this module, and I'll explain how we're going to set this up. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to create a user, Joe, on the system, and Joe is going to be allowed to run to manage only the ntpd service, basically edit some files that are ntp related and restart the server, stop the servers, and stuff like that. Now how are we going to do that? So we're going to use the staff login user role, the staff view, maybe you heard of it, the SE Linux user, which is basically a confined user that has access to sudo, and that can basically change to a privileged role, in this case the myntpd ntp admin role. So we need to basically add a rule that allows staff role access to the myntp admin role. So we're going to add another rule which is similar to this, which this rule allows the ntp admin role access to the system role. This is needed for ntp admin to be able to start the service on behalf of the system. Now we're going to basically allow the staff role access to the my ntp admin role. So staff r, allow staff r access to the my ntp admin role, and then we're going to have to require the staff role, of course, because else it won't work. Yeah, you need to basically include it. So the staff role is here now included. Let's see if this builds. It's still building, so let's just install this. Sudo se module e my ntp admin pp. So this is going to install it, but I need passwords. That sucks. Let's see if I can. Oh, this is the user password, right? Yeah, right. So yeah, I don't use this password often, so I'm going to have to type here. We were from some paper, because the system is almost never used by me. It's an old system. It's a game server that I have, and dedicated hardware. Jesus Christ. Sorry. But that's what you get. Hopefully I will be able to type this password without errors, because it's a huge password. Give me a break. Give me a freaking break. Okay, let's try this once more. Something is not right here. Maybe the password. seems this time I typed it properly. This is such a huge password. So we have some issues here. It's basically crying about an requirement that is not met, and that is right. This is the systemd unit file type that we required here, but it's not available in this system. So we can just remove this one here, and it'll fix it. And just do this fast so that I don't have to type the sudo password again, or the user password again to authenticate. So now it's hopefully loading. So this was just an error message because the policy included some type that is that is unknown, and that's because Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6 doesn't have systemd and does not have the systemd entropy unit file type. But anyways, so now we have this setup. We have this module. It was pretty simple, but this was a module basically based on an API that is already existing. But you could create this yourself as well easily. But if you want to do that and you need help, then you'll just have to ask me or just figure it out yourself. But it's possible easily. So anyways, we have this setup. So let's just set up a user and stuff like that. So let's just sudo user at Joe. I guess user at Joe, and a password Joe, and I'm going to we can only specify sudo password Joe. I need to use sudo. Alright, so now I'm going to use the same stupid password as this user. So this is going to take a while. See if I can type this one without errors two times. Wouldn't be surprised if I can't. This one is huge. Oh, it did. So okay, so the password is updated, stuff like that. So we have this user here. I'll probably have some other stuff that I need to take care of. For example, sudo less etc. Let's just groups. And I have this user, which is WXM43N, and we have wheel, and we have no SSH user, so that's not set up. All right, so we have this user now, but we need to map it and we need to set it up. So how do we go about that? Now, first, let's just create a new user, SE Linux user. So currently we have sudo SE manage user list, and hopefully I have the SE manage command installed. SE manage, not SE module. And it is installed. So we currently have these users. Now what I'm going to do right now is create a new user. So sudo SE manage user at default sensitivity of S0, a range of S0, S0, C0, C1023, and then we're going to assign roles to this user. So which roles do we need? Well, first of all, we need to basically add a staff role, because this is going to be the default login user role. And then we're going to add our myNTP admin role. And third, we're going to need to use the system R role, because this user needs to be able to basically manage services on behalf of the system. So that's basically why that's done. So now let's just add it, and we are going to call this new SE Linux user myNTP admin U. Right, so now it's adding that. Now I'm going okay, we have a bad option, so let's see. Oh yeah, right, this is user and then, so I forgot the prefix. The P is for prefix, user prefix, and all the user prefixes are user U, as you can see in this list here. User, 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 user. So now this is set up. Hopefully if it speeds up a little bit, it's old system, bit slow. Alright, so now come on, hurry up. This is slow. Give me a break, give me a break, give me a break. This takes long. Slow. So let's list it again and list it with our new user. So now we have this myntp-admin U, it's a Linux user, and it's mapped to staff, system R, and myntp-admin. So now basically we could just map the new Joe user, was it? We call it Joe, yeah. Map this Joe user to the new myntp-admin U. So let's do that. sudo login, and then add, and then s myntp admin underscore u, and then we add a range of s0 s0 c0 c10 1023, and then that is for the user Joe. So now it creates a mapping, it creates an association between Joe and myntp admin. So Joe is myntp admin. So let's list that. Sudo sumanage login l to list the logins. And now you can see that there is a login added for our Joe user. So our Joe user is mapped, is associated to the myntp admin u underscore u user. Now we need to take care of PAM. PAM basically tells the login programs which context it should use when a user logs in. Now since we created a new SE Linux user, we need to basically adjust that. So I'm going to basically sudo cp and then etc SE Linux targeted context users, and then I'm going to copy the staff u file to etc SE Linux targeted and then context users, and I'll call this myntp admin u. So this is basically a way to set that up. So I'll cp that, it's cp'd, and now I'm going to edit the myntpd admin u file, nano that, to reflect our new user. So instead of star view, I'm going to just do the following. So this user is, let's just assume that this user only logs in via SSH and not via local login, not via remote login. It doesn't do cron, doesn't do XDM, and so basically, and doesn't need access to sysadmin, so we can basically leave that out as well, and also this can be removed because sysadmin is not involved. So let's call this myntp admin. I could just use seps for this, but basically all references to staff are going to get changed to myntp admin. myntp admin, and so forth and so forth. And this might seem a little bit hard, but it's very powerful, and once you get the hang of it, you can create all your confined administrators without much problem. It's pretty easy to do. So change this as well, myntp admin. All the references to staff need to be changed. You just use the staff as a template. We could have used some else. Jesus, I need to watch my typos. And my Twitter is crapping out. Piece of shit. So myntp admin. Okay, that seems okay right about now. So now we have that set up as well. So now basically we should be done, except that we need to give this access, this user access to sudo. So sudo nano etc sudoers d pseudo-SD Joe. And then basically tell that Joe, and then this could be done better, but I'll just use all is all, but you can basically make this more, adjust this more to your stuff. And then say type NTP, my NTP, NTP admin T, and role is my NTP admin R, and then all. And this should basically allow or tell sudo that if Joe runs the sudo command, that he should automatically change to the myntp admin. And we can override this if we'd like to. And then basically tmod 0440. All right. So now let's see if I have some other security in place. Let's etc security access conf, link all the way below. No, I don't have any other security in place. So let's open up a new shell and see if I can actually log in now. And this is basically SSH, and then it's Joe, and it's called it's at node 192.168.1.102, and it's at O port is elite. And the password. So, oh yeah, I haven't set up. Shit, I haven't set up PKI yet. So I'm not sure if my SSH requires PKI or if it's going to allow me to actually log in using the password. If not, then I'll need to set that up as well. And it's not. Oh, this is unable to get a valid invalid context for. Damn, that's my administration there. Enabled. So let's just have a look at that. Sudo less var log secure. There's some issue going on here. And this is wrong. Need the right shell here. This less var log secure sudo it, and hopefully I don't have to type password. No, so basically it's not allowed. So there's some issues here. My NTP admin SSH. So it seems that I messed something up here. So let's just have a look. Is it called my NTP admin? My NTP admin. Is this set up? Do I have any typos? Doesn't seem to be any typos there. Let's have a look. That this my NTP admin U, this is really my NTP admin U. Let's just try this again. Sorry, that's, but let's just try this again. Somewhere it's just not doing it right. My NTP admin, and I'm making a mistake somewhere. That sucks. So I'll just do it the hard way and then later clean it up a little bit. There's some mistake. It doesn't know which context to use, and this file is responsible for that. But somehow either I made a mistake in this file, or I did something else, and that's basically not nice, but that's the way it is. And really isn't hard, just, but yeah, there's of course always possibility that you make some stupid simple mistake. but it really shouldn't be hard at all. And maybe it's just related to me. Oh, this is sysadmin. Okay, so now this one here. Actually, this is the issue. Actually, no, save. You shouldn't have to change it at all. Sorry, I was confused. This is already all right. No, you don't. You just need to copy it. You don't have to change it. Yeah, I was confused. So, let's go back. Where the hell is it? Where is that shell here? So let's try this again. So yeah, that's sorry that I made that a little bit more confusing than it is, than it has to be. Let's try login again. And now I'm logged in. So let's look at my ID. My ID is staff in the but I'm my NTP admin you. So now basically I should be able to run a sudo, and let's just run sudo in the shell, So let's just do that and type password. So now we have a shell in the NTP admin. So now we are NTP administrator. So when we log in by default, we're just a normal user. We're just staff or user. We are just staff, just an unprivileged user. But if the user wants to manage the basically the system, then basically he needs to run sudo. Now as sudo as he can't do anything or not much. He can't see the procs, which sucks. Because he should actually be able to see the process of NTP of the NTP service. For some reason, it doesn't see it. So we should probably figure out why that is. Top also doesn't work. But if I do the following: service NTP D stop. I'm not sure if it's NTP D or NTP. Then actually that works. So as you can see, and if I do start, it actually works. Start. So, but it, let's see, let's assume I do this for something else. Let's try SSH. Service, SSH, SSHD probably, and then stop. Or restart, let's just restart, because if it for some reason does, then SSHD doesn't even, and doesn't even see the service. So let's see, do I have any other, well, Jesus Christ. PS out, do I have any other system services that I could mess with? Or for example, here's SSHD, but didn't even find it. Let's see if I can, let's just try syslog, yeah, I'm not sure. Let's just try audit. So, audit the restart. It doesn't even recognize the service, so you can't mess with it. But I can actually start and stop the NTPD service. So now let's see what else we could do. We could, for example, edit the NTPD temp file, which probably isn't here right now, but the PID file. So where is the NTP PID file supposed to be? So let's have a look. LSRZ, and this is the normal root shell, and sudo, but it's probably already. Oh yeah, we're still there. And then var run, and then there should be some NTP stuff in here. NTPD pit. So we should have access, and we already know we have access because by restarting the services NTPD admin you can see it. The file gets created with the identity of NTP the admin you. So I could basically go ahead and nano var run And then it's NTPD PIT, probably, was it? And there you have it. So I could basically edit this file if I'd like to. Hello world. But it's not allowed. Oh yeah, it's allowed. Sorry, it is allowed. Because if I do it again, you'll see that hello world is here. But there was some other error, unrelated. But you can basically create this, refine it better. But the point I'm trying to make is that if you want some confined administrator that has very limited access on the system, then you should use you should create a new role and use the available policy to you, but don't mess with existing modules, because if you're going to change the user role to allow it to run sudo, then you're breaking the policy module. And if you're going to get another job and someone else comes in there and he has to deal with your policy, and you're making all kinds of irrational decisions and changed the policy in all kinds of weird ways, then there's just no way for your coworker to actually figure out what the heck is going on in the system, because you broke the policy. So, and this makes sense. All this does is basically create a new module, add a new module. It doesn't actually change the policy all that much, except that it allows staff role access to the myadmin role. That's basically all. But it just adds on some new stuff. So basically now we have created a myadmin, NTP admin role. And you can do this for HTTPD or for sets of services, for just files. You can do whatever you want with just a few single policy lines, but you need to make a clear goal. You need to make a planning and say, okay, I want this confined administrator, this confined route, to only be able to do this, and that, and then you need to work towards your goal. So that's basically it. I'm going to save, get out of here, and I'm going to upload this, and hopefully if you have questions, then I'll hear that.